Good morning, students. Today we are going to see Unit 6, Prose, From 0 to Infinity, Biography of Srinivasa Ramanujan. First, let us know the meaning of this word infinity and biography. Infinity means unlimited or countless. It may be in numbers, time, or quantity. And this biography, what is the difference between autobiography and biography? So this autobiography is a self-written account, okay, which means one who writes about their life themselves. They write about their life, okay, and this biography is an account of someone's life written by someone else. Okay. Here it means someone has written about Srinivasa Ramanujan. Okay. So we all know that Srinivasa Ramanujan was an Indian mathematician. He lived during the British rule in India. So let us know more about his life from this lesson. A classroom situation is given here. So the arithmetic class was going on, max classes going on, and the teacher was teaching and solving problems in division. She drew three bananas on the blackboard and she pointed three boys who were in the class and asked then how many each would get. So a smart boy among the students, he stood up quickly and answered that each would get one. The teacher appreciated the student and asked a similar question, a related question to that division. If 1,000 bananas are distributed, okay, if 1,000 bananas are distributed among 1,000 boys, again each boy would get one. So while the teacher was explaining this, a boy seated in the corner, so that boy was Ramanujan, he stood up and asked a question. So his question is, if no banana was distributed among no one, would anyone still get one banana? So his question is, there is no banana. But if we distribute no banana, will students get it? So on hearing this, the students started laughing. The students laughed at Ramanujan. Now the teacher controlled the students by patting on the table, the desk, and explained what Ramanujan meant by his question. If zero banana is divided by zero, no one will get one. So mathematically, each will get an infinite number of bananas. So zero divided by zero is zero. So no one will get one. But this time, with laughter, the boys understood the trick of mathematics. So the teacher appreciated Ramanujan. But still the students can't able to understand why the teacher is appreciating Ramanujan. The experts in mathematics took several centuries to answer this question. Some experts declared that 0 divided by 0 is 0. But few said it's unity, which means the state of being one. The state of being one. Ramanujan was born in Erode on December 22, 1887. His father was a clerk in a cloth shop. So he is doing a clerical work. So this Ramanujan had so much ability even in his early childhood. His senior students used to get his help in solving maths problem. Even his senior students, okay, the boys who are who were aged, okay, the big boys used to ask his help to solve problems in maths. At the age of 13, he began his own research on trigonometry. That means the study of triangles. He got such advancement by a book written by S.L. Loney. He put forward many theorems and formula which is not given in the book. So he started to do sums which is not given in books. One of his senior friends gave him a book named Elementary Results in Pure Applied Mathematics, okay, which is written by George Shoebridge Carr. So one of his friend gave him a book, okay, and this book, it is a collection of 4,865 formulas and theorems. So Ramanujan began to work with it. He started to put those problems, those sums. So that book triggered and motivated the genius in Ramanujan. He is able to solve the sums easily in his mind. Okay. So he used to do problems on loose sheets of paper or on a slate. And he wrote the results in notebooks. So the answers, he has written the answers in the notebooks. Before he went to abroad, he had finished 3 notebooks, okay, which are now famous as Ramanujan's Frayed Notebooks. So now also it is very famous. He has solved many complicated problems in those 3 notebooks. In the matriculation examination, Ramanujan got first class in mathematics and was awarded the Subramanian scholarship. So he got scholarship also. But he failed twice in his first year arts examination in college, as he did not concentrate on other subjects like history, English and physiology. He is not interested in other subjects. He is only interested in maths, so he didn't concentrate on any other subjects. So he got failed in those subjects. So this made his father upset, as he failed in other subjects, made his father upset. And he also thought that Ramanujan had gone mad, as he always scribbles numbers without doing other work. So his opinion is, Ramanujan is always scribbling something in the papers. Just numbers. He is writing just numbers without studying other subjects, and as well as he is not concentrating on other works. Ramanujan searched for job. So not only for food, but for papers, to buy papers. Okay, so papers to do calculations, to do sums. So he needed about 2000 sheets of paper every month to do calculations. So usually he used to get papers, okay, 2000 sheets of paper every month. So he won't leave a small bit of paper which is lying on the streets. Even he is not leaving any papers in the ground. Even he used written papers. Okay, so he used to overwrite using red pen if it is written in blue. So even it is written something in that paper, he still scribbles the numbers. He used to do calculations. If that paper is if something is written in blue, he used red pen to overwrite it. Overwrite to do sums. Ramanujan went to visit office with his notebooks and his application. So to get job, he used to go to office, okay, for interviews with his application and as well as with his notebooks. He shows it to everyone, telling them that he knew mathematics and could do a clerk job. But no one understood what was written in the notebooks. So they are not able to find what is written in that notebook. But luckily, Francis Spring, the director of Madras Port Trust, got impressed by Ramanujan's notebooks and gave him a clerical job. He got rupees 25 as his monthly salary. Then some teachers and educationalists who were interested in maths provide Ramanujan with a research fellowship. So many of them understood his talent and provided some jobs, and as well as they learnt maths from him. So later the University of Madras gave him a fellowship of rupees 75 per month. So until months he was getting 25 rupees, and now he got a job and the salary is 75 per month. Within months, Ramanujan sent a letter to the great mathematician G.H. Hardy of Cambridge University, in which he set out 120 theorems and formula, which included the Riemann series. So he has sent a letter along with 120 theorems and formula. Okay. So Hardy and his colleague Littlewood realized that they had discovered a rare mathematical genius. So going through all those sums, this Hardy and his co-worker, okay, Littlewood realized his mathematical genius. Then they invited him to Britain. On March 17, 1914, he sailed from Britain. He started to travel to Britain. So being a vegetarian, he had to cook himself and was hard to bear the cold weather. So it was very cold there and he is not able to bear it. So Ramanujan continued his research with determination in the company and Hardy and Littlewood in the company of theirs. Okay. Ramanujan was elected as a member of the Royal Society on February 28, 1918. So he was the youngest Indian to receive it. He was the youngest Indian, okay, to get that Royal Society. Okay, elected as a member in the Royal Society. In October, he became the first Indian to be elected fellow of Trinity College, Cambridge. So he was elected as a member in the Trinity College, which was in Cambridge. Ramanujan's achievements include the Hardy Ramanujan Littlewood circle method. So Hardy Ramanujan Littlewood circle method in number theory. In algebra, his work on continued fractions is considered to be equal in importance to that of great mathematicians like Leonhard Euler and Jacob. So he was compared with other mathematicians also. And this Ramanujan suffered from tuberculosis, which is an incurable lung disease. So he suffered from that tuberculosis. So Ramanujan was sent back to India. As he is suffering, he is not feeling well, he is sent back to India. When he arrived, his friends found him exhausted, pale, thin and weak. So he was looking very thin and weak. Even on his deathbed, he played with numbers to forget his pain. So even in pain, he started to calculate. He used to put sums in notebooks. Besides being a mathematician, Ramanujan was an astrologer and a good speaker too. He used to give lectures on subjects like God, zero and infinity. So this is the lesson given about Ramanujan.